JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 16th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded higher against all the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It gained the most versus NOK, Aussie, Kiwi and the Canadian dollar in that order, while it decked out the least gains against the yen and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakening of the risk-linked and oil-related currencies combined with the relative strength of the safe havens suggests that market participants traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity sphere, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of red, with the downbeat appetite rolling into the Asian session today. You can see that Japan's Nikkei was down 0.92%, and China's and Hong Kong's Hang Seng was down 0.75%, although we saw China Shanghai Composite and South Korea's KOSPI staying virtually unchanged, slightly positive, let's say. Now, following the acceleration in both infected cases and deaths from the coronavirus for Tuesday, investors received another reality check by the more than expected tumble in the US retail sales for March, which suggested that the damages of the US economy during the month may have been larger than previously anticipated. Most importantly, at least in our view, the New York Empire State Manufacturing Index for April tumbled to a record low of -78.20 from -21.5, suggesting that the wounds of the manufacturing sector dragged into the second quarter of the year, despite some signs that the virus was slowing down. This raises questions as to whether the market at ISM manufacturing PMIs for the US as a whole will disappoint as well. Paradoxically, it appears that disappointing US data work against equities but in favor of the US dollar. This may have been the case due to the fact that in a dollar-denominated world, during periods of high turbulence and uncertainty, market participants likely prefer to liquidate their assets and hold cash. In other words, the US dollar appears to be wearing its safe haven suit recently. Now, on top of the disappointing US data, what may have also weighed on investors' morale may have been the further acceleration in cases and deaths for Wednesday, with deaths hitting a new daily record. You can see it here. The blue line is the daily change in deaths, while the gray line is the daily change in infected cases. Anything pointing to the upside marks an acceleration, while anything pointing to the downside marks a slowdown. So we saw further acceleration with deaths hitting a new daily record. You can see it here, higher than the previous one, the previous peak. Remember that we have been repeatedly noting that just a day of new records may be enough to revive fears and trigger another round of risk aversion. Now it remains to be seen whether the latest acceleration is the exemption of a broader slowdown or whether the latest slowdown was just a pause in the exponential spreading. Yesterday's statistics and market reaction confirm our view to stay reluctant in trusting a long-lasting recovery in the broader sentiment and instead take things day by day. we will continue in that mode, and we believe that another round of accelerating virus cases may bring equities and risk-linked assets lower, while safe havens may shine. The opposite may be true if we get a slowdown. Having said all that, today investors may lock their gaze for another week to the US initial jobless claims for the week ended on April 10th. After hitting a record of 6.87 million 3 weeks ago, we got another surge the following week, with the report revealing 6.61 million new claims. Now the forecast points to 5.11 million, but bearing in mind that both prior reports have exceeded estimates, we wouldn't be surprised if we get another number above the 6 million mark. Something like that may signal that the damages in the labor market are more severe than previously anticipated, could bring equities and risk-linked currencies under selling pressure. The safe havens dollar, yen and franc may be the main beneficiaries among the G10 currencies. Now, elsewhere, the loonie and the Norwegian crown may have felt the heat of the slide in oil prices. Both WTI and Brent slid 1.20 and 6.45% respectively after the Energy Information Administration reported its biggest weekly inventory build on record, something that may have increased concerns that the weekend output cut agreement between the OPEC Plus members may not be enough to offset the tumble in demand due to the fast-spreading pandemic. We also had a Bank of Canada policy decision yesterday, but with all the attention on the US data and the virus saga, it may have gained less attention than it could have otherwise. The bank decided to keep interest rates unchanged at 0.25%, repeating that this is the effective lower bound, but decided to expand its QE purchases. Officials noted that they will temporarily increase purchases of treasury bills to up to 40% while they announced two new programs, a provincial bond purchase program of up to 15 billion Canadian dollars and a corporate bond one of up to 10 billion Canadian dollars. Today during the Asian morning we got Australia's employment report for March, which came in better than expected, but the Aussie barely reacted, staying a victim of the broader risk-off environment. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European morning, we get Germany's final inflation data for March, but as it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. Eurozone's industrial production for February is also due to be released, and the forecast points to a 0.2 month-over-month slide after a 2.3% increase in January. From the US, apart from the initial jobless claims, we have building permits and housing starts for March, as well as the Philly Fed Manufacturing Index for April. Both building permits and housing starts are expected to have declined somewhat, while the Philly Fed Index is forecast to have slid to minus 30 from minus 12.7. Similarly, with the New York Empire State Index, a larger decline could be an early sign that the damages in the manufacturing sector would drag more than previously estimated. As for tonight, during the Asian session Friday, we get China's GDP for the first quarter, as well as retail sales, industrial production, and fixed asset investment, all for March. The nation's economy is all but certain to have shrunk in the first 3 months of the year due to the coronavirus outbreak, with the market consensus pointing to a 6% year-over-year contraction. Retail sales, industrial production, fixed asset investment are all expected to have continued sliding in March, but at a slower pace than in February. Bearing in mind that the spreading of the virus in China slowed notably during the third month of this year, we wouldn't be surprised if we get better readings. The big question is whether the economy has started recovering in the second quarter after the nation has lifted several restrictive measures. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. Now, at this point, I have to inform you that we will not have a daily market review tomorrow, neither a weekly Market Outlook webinar on Monday. So you will get to hear from me again on Tuesday. Okay, so goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again here next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.